Lang po lang ng Psych 101. Yeah, first slide please. After bridging leadership. Sino nagko-control ng slide? Ayan. Sige. Bigyan ko lang background para maintindihan. Study of human behavior, human beings in relationship with others. I apologize kasi sa kakulangan ng oras babasahin ko. Pero meron lang akong ilang side remarks. Gusto kong idagdag dito sa study of human beings and relationship with others ay hindi lang human beings but also a relationship with other living things, like animals and plants. Ang tawag doon, eco-psych. It's all about humans, in other words, body, mind, and spirit. But gusto ko yung underscore na ang madalas nating pinag-aaralan ay body lang at saka mind. Pero nakakalimutan na bahagi ng pag-aaral ang spirit, the heart and the soul. At ito ang most neglected. Components, ito ang gagay-gayin natin ngayong umaga, ay ngayong tanghali. Cognitive is knowledge, affective, attitudes and emotion, and behavior, which are the practices. Ang nakakaligtaan palagi sa diskusyon ay yung affect, yung emotions, at saka yung actual practices. Okay, what is, I'm pressing it, next slide please. So what is Psikolohiyang Pilipino? Ito ay natutunan ko sa aking profesor. I like to pay homage to him, si Dr. Virgilio Enriquez. Naging estudyante ako in the 70s. At siya ang nagdala ng, or yung founder ng Psikolohiyang Pilipino. Marami noong reservations sa applicability of Western models in the Philippine and the Asian context. Sapagkat ang pagtingin sa tao ay iba. For example, masyadong individualistic at self-oriented, self, I, me, my, and the other-oriented, ang psikolohiya. Tayo ay galing sa hindi individualistic societies, kundi collectivist societies. We are more group-oriented. Ganun na lang muna, mahabang diskusyon. The Psikolohiyang Pilipino is anchored on Filipino perspectives, thought, and experience. I will discuss that later. It's the study of various concepts at conceptuals. Diwa, isip, malay, ulirat, at marami pang iba. Lahat itong mga binanggit ko to ay isa-isang pinag-aralan conceptually. It's based on Philippine history and culture. Ibig sabihin, linalagay sa konteksto yung ating 300 years of Spain or Vatican and 100 years of Hollywood. Okay, sabi nga nila, yun daw ang summation ng history. Gusto ko lang underscore kasi i-discuss ko rin ang importance ng language aside from the importance of culture. Language is the core of culture. And culture is a way of life but also is the mirror of our souls and our spirit. So doon lang i-anchor ang ating discussion. Direction, next slide please. Next slide please. Ala, wala nang nagsaslide.
Doc Elmer.
Yep, sandali lang may live.
Okay. Kasi wala akong slide sa harap. Ayaw. Ayaw pumasok. Ay, nahanap ko yung slide ko.
Mauna na kayo, ihabol na lang yung slide.
Oo, kaya lang, kailangan buksan ko yung akin kasi hindi nakabukas eh. Sandali. Ito na. Yan ang problema. Hindi ko sinabay, hindi ko binuksan. So, dali ha. Binubuksan ko lang. So, ang susunod na slide actually, at ito ang core ng ating pag-uusap ngayon, ay yung pagkataong Pilipino. Sapagkat dito natin makikita ang pagkatao ng isang leader. In fact, alam ko na ang discussion natin ngayon ay bahagi ng isang leadership series. Okay? So, ang tanong na ating sasagutin ay, sino ang taong Pilipino? Okay? Loosely translated sa English, minsan sinasabi yan ay personality or identity. Again, loosely translated, tinatanong sa iyo, sino ako? Who am I? Sino ang ibang tao? Who is the other? Pero sa sikolohiyang Pilipino, sa sikolohiya ng pagkataong Pilipino, ang sinasabi ay ang pagka is the and then tao is the other word, the root word. Kasi sa Filipino language, napakatindi ng affixation natin. At makikita natin yan mamaya. So, it is the art of being human, possessing the characteristics of bilang tao. In that sense, napakaganda na. Hindi lang siya personality characteristic. Of course, kailangan ding malaman ano yung mga characteristics na ito ng Pilipino at in the end, kailangan sagutin, dala-dala ba ito ng isang Pilipino leader? So, diretso na ako sa framework. Next slide, please. Ang konsepto ng pagkataong Pilipino ay nakapaloob dito sa konsepto ng banga. Didiscuss ko isa-isa ito later, pero ngayon gusto ko lang i-point out, andyan yung loob, which at the core of it, andyan yung labas, which is nasa paligid niya. Sa loob, may mababaw, may malalim. Sa mababaw, sa labas, ang kategorya doon ay ibang tao. Pag ikaw ay nasa loob na, hindi ka na ibang tao. At malalim na yun. Nakapaligid at napakaikot dito, higit pa sa labas, ay yung mas malawak na pananaw at saka yung medyo makitid na pananaw. At dito makikita, nasa gitna at nakapaloob sa lahat ang kapwa. Hindi ko isa-isahin ngayon yan kasi part bahagi yan ng aking susunod na mga slides. Next slide please. Okay. Ang direksyon ng diagram na yon ay mula sa labas patungo sa loob. Pero kailangan lumabas din. Kaya mula sa loob patungo sa labas. Mula sa mababaw patungo sa malalim. Pwede rin naman malalim patungo sa mababaw although hindi masyadong nangyayari yon. Mula sa makitid patungo sa malawak. Mula sa ibang tao patungo sa ibang tao. At ang buod nito ay kapwa ng pagkataong Pilipino. Again, i-discuss ko to isa-isa. So next slide please. So makikita natin dito ang pinaka-importanting konsepto ng connectedness. May tumatawag na connectivity. Sa sikulihan Pilipino, ang tawag namin dito ay antas ng pagtutunguhan o levels of interaction, levels of interconnectedness, levels of relationship. Sa isang banda, merong ibang tao concept, outsider, not one of us. Itong levels na to ay sequential, okay? Mula sa labas patungo sa loob. Pakikitungo, translation, civility with, pakikisalamuha, interaction with, pakikilahok, joining and participating, pakikibagay in conformity with, in accordance with, and pakikisama, getting along with. I just want to underscore the fact ng bawat level na to ay pinag-aralan conceptually and methodologically pero hindi natin madadaanan lahat ngayon. Next slide please. Sa ibang tao, ang ibang tao, tinatawag na hindi ibang tao kasi insider siya, one of us. Sa levels na ito ng interconnectedness, nandyan ang pagpalagayang loob. It is a level of mutual trust, understanding, and acceptance. Actually, this is the ideal level to achieve if you make a choice on how far you want to go in your connectedness sa pagpasok sa loob. Pakikisangkot, getting involved with, is getting deeper into the relationship at pakikiisa, being one with or commitment. Hindi lahat ng relasyon kailangang umabot sa pakikiisa. Pwedeng manatili kayo sa isang level depende sa antas ng pakikipagtunguhan nyo sa relasyon ninyo sa ibang tao o sa hindi ibang tao. Ngayon sa wika nga natin, itong introduction ko sa kapwa, sa wika natin ay merong pronouns of inclusion and exclusion. And it's very interesting. Sila is they, inclusive we us including, kayo, others, kami, exclusive we, us not including you, kita, you and I, dual we. I'll give the example of kita just to learn to appreciate the language. Bihira may mga wika na combined ang you and I. So for example, I love you is subject-object, subject-verb-object, one way. ako, mahal ikaw, loosely translated. Pero sa atin, mahal kita, ina-assume nila yung I. Pero hindi, yung kita kasi is I and you together. So if I say I love you or mahal kita, ang assumption doon, reciprocal, mahal din kita. Okay? Diba? Ang ganda. Anyway, just a cute example. Kapwa is actually at the core. Kapwa is actually not just we. It is I, you, and we together as one. It's almost like the concept of humanity, which I will discuss again later. So next slide, please. We have to understand also that in culture, in Filipino culture, there are different patterns of communication and behavior. This is oversimplified, no? At maraming examples that could be exceptions to the rule. But this is more of a generalization, again, based on research. The Western mode of communication is more direct, okay? Filipinos are more direct. So maraming paligoy-ligoy, maraming pahiwatig, at minsan dinadaan sa biro, dinadaan sa lambing. All of these concepts are indirect ways of communicating, but still communicating to make a point. Western way is formal, non-Western way is informal, and because the Western way is more hierarchical and the Filipino way is more vertical, no, more horizontal, not vertical. Kaya lahat equal, lahat pantay-pantay. It's also impersonal, so Western way. As a Filipino way, it's personal. So ibig sabihin, huwag kayong maniwala na trabaho lang, walang personalan. May kasamang personal yun palagi, maski na sa mga politiko at maski na sa mga leaders. So written more than ang Western, ang Filipino more oral, ang tradition. Okay? Hindi ibig sabihin hindi tayo natutong magsulat, kaya lang ang pinaka-effective means of transmission sa atin ay harapan, face-to-face or oral. Kaya napakahirap nitong COVID. So anyway, yung isa pa ay yung verbal, okay? Tayo mas non-verbal. Marami tayong non-verbal cues. Paano mo malalaman yun? Huwag kang mag-alala kasi culture bearer ka, Pilipino ka, natutunan mo na yan as you grew up. And then of course, external versus internal. Mas nanggagaling sa loob ang ating patterns of communication. Kaya mas personal. Kaya palaging emotional, may affect. Okay? Next slide, please. At the core of all this is kapwa. As I said earlier, it's I, you, and we together. Hindi naintindihan ito ng mga tagalabas o ng mga Western scholars kasi it's a shared identity. It's I and you together as one. Okay? That's why it's very interesting because there is no real one word for it. Because what affects you affects me in a very direct way and I'm a part of you. That's why it's pakikipagkapwa tao, treating the other as a fellow human being. Isipin nyo lahat ng ka, kapatid, kaibigan, kabyak, kumag-anak, kaaway, kasama, kabit, etc. Both positive and negative valuations. Okay? Ang ibang tao at hindi ibang tao ay parehong kapwa sa ating bokabularyo ng psikolohiyang Pilipino. Next slide, please. So, importanteng behavioral component doon ay pakikipagkapwa-ta. Now, what is the methodology or what is the bridge or what is the anchoring? How are we going to use all these values, virtues? We use the simple thing called pakiramdam. Paki is please, ramdam is to feel. But actually, it's a loose translation. When you say pakiramdam, sinasabi natin, pakigamit ang inyong pandama, all your five senses, including the sixth one, which is the intuitive one, which in more ways than one are the better ones, the less rational, the less logical. It's a shared inner perception. It's a heightened sensitivity. It's a feeling for the other. Okay? So sinasabi natin, pakigamit ang inyong pakiramdam, makiramdam kayo. Kaya sa sikulihang Pilipino, meron kaming methodology ng pakapakapa, which sounds funny because in English, it's translated as groping technique. Pero I believe you, it works. The pakapakapa method is also a pakiramdam method. Nakikiramdam, nararamdaman, pero interestingly, tingnan nyo, may karamdaman. Hindi sinabing may sakit. May karamdaman kasi may affect. Next slide, please. Social personal values, pasok tayo sa loob. Ang loob, marami ng pag-aaral, iba-ibang mga psychologists, philosophers. Andyan, it's translated as inner self or will. Andyan ang lakas ng loob, tibay ng loob, sama ng loob. Maraming pwedeng ikabit sa loob. Okay? But it's interesting because it's what lies within your kalooban. Kaya pagka ikaw ay binayulate within, nilooban ka. Okay? Understood in relation to kapwa. How one relates and acts towards kapwa. Dagdagan pa natin ng ilang beautiful concepts ng loob. Kabutihang loob, good inside. Kagandahang loob, beautiful inside. And kalinisang loob, clean inside. Notice these are gradients of you may necessarily be good. You have to be good, but you don't always have to be kind. That's an extra step. And you can be good and kind, but you don't have to have always kalinisan ng loob. Kalinisan ng loob is almost like not thinking bad about somebody in mind, body, and spirit. I think people like this are a candidate for sainthood, but that's my personal opinion. Next slide, please. Utang na loob, okay, is another concept of loob. Loosely translated by Western scholars, it was considered as a debt of gratitude, reciprocity, repayment with interest. This was questioned a lot by scholars. And the basic question you ask is, ang utang na loob ba ay binabayaran? Hindi po. Ang utang na loob tinatanaw. You don't focus on the utang because there is no equivalent value. You focus on the loob because it is priceless. And because ang utang na loob, across generations, tinatanaw mo. Mga ninuno mo, mga magulang mo, mga kasama mo, etc. And napakalaking bagay pag wala kang utang na loob. It's considered negative. Next slide, please. Marami kong examples doon and I'm tempted, pero I will move on. Bahala na. Again, you know, this was studied by Dr. Lagmay, the founder of Department of Psychology, and it's bathala na. And notice that bathala in our language connotes a higher being or a higher consciousness. But loosely translated by Western scholars, it was considered fatalistic behavior. Whatever, who cares, there's no plan, etc. And we have always been labeled as bahala na people. But in reality, if you study bahala na, it is lakas ng loob. You've done your best. You've done everything within your power. And you leave the rest to a higher consciousness, a higher being. It's courage, it's fortitude, it's positive confrontation in the midst of uncertainty, ambiguity, and unpredictability. And that's what the present situation is. So when we say bahala na, we carry with us the act of courage because we've done our best and are continue to do our best. It is the sacrifice of the self for kapwa, as we say now popularly, the word is malasakit. Next slide, please. Hiya, literally translated again by Western scholars, is shame. Put mildly, it is shy feeling embarrassed. Can you imagine psychologists like us studying this, saying it is shame? If you are ashamed, you must have sinned. If you sinned, then you are guilty. If you are guilty, then you have to ask for sorry or apologize. If you apologize, then there is repentance or there is penance. Down the line of the sin, guilt, and repentance framework. And that's why we are all feeling guilty. But it is not. Hiya is not that. It is a kind of sensitivity, a sense of propriety in order not to offend the other. Actually, hiya is not easy to translate in one word. There is no one word translation. But in a nutshell, it's also an Asian concept which is related to the loss of face. Or the loss of dignity. In other words, you don't like to magpahiya kasi ayaw mo ring mapahiya ka. Again, notice the nuancing in terms of the affixations. You have to have the root word, but when you put the affix on the different words, it changes the meaning. It is a quality of one's loob that makes one sacrifice for the sake of kapwa. It is really a continuum of merong hiya to walang hiya. So we should not tell people that wag silang mahiya or tanggalin nila ang hiya. Kasi pag tinanggal nila yon, magiging walang hiya sila. Again, which is a very negative concept in our culture. Hiya is the closest to the concept of loss of face and loss of dignity. And operationalizing hiya means we are upholding our honor and our dignity.
Next. Prof. Beth?
Yes.
Well, 1 minute po.
Oh.
Sige, synthesis in a way. Go ahead po.
Tawad.
Last.
So, eto na. A Filipino leader should be the embodiment of genuine pagkataong Filipino characteristics, can relate to others in various levels of interaction, interconnectedness, upholds and practices Filipino values in his and her personal life and governance. And in a nutshell, makatao, maka-Pilipino, maka-Diyos. And some want me to add makalikasan, although that was not part of our study. But I would like to use the other 1 minute for something that's not in the slide, which was my food thought as I prepared.
Go ahead.
Mabilis lang, okay? And this is related to leadership in general, okay? What my observation now in this COVID crisis, in this uncertain, ambiguous, and unpredictable times is that there is an emerging leadership that is not hierarchical, but vertical or co-equal, that comes from a collective consciousness. We are no longer looking at a one-person leader or the great, dear leader or the good leader or the ideal leader. But we are looking at groups of people who are brought together to respond to a situation based on articulated needs of the moment, okay? And therefore, what type, what are the characteristics, or how do we know these emerging leaderships? They will usually come from informal leaders in various sectors, the ones that are sprouting now, in many cases, attending to various needs, making PPEs, helping doctors in the front line, the police, whoever is the emerging leader. It is organically grown. In other words, the seeds are planted by our culture, and therefore it's almost automatic that we help others. That's the point of organically grown. It's also new and innovative. Gone are the old ways of structural, you know, structures of governance that go down the lines of the bureaucracy and so on and so forth. It's not about emergency powers. It's really about new and creative ways or co-creative ways. It's really out of thinking. And then finally, it's resilient. Resilience in a nutshell in psychology is described as the ability to survive beautifully against all the odds, against all the circumstances. And finally, I would like to end with deliverables. Okay, because this public health crisis wants us also to be accountable to each other and to our community. I would like to call on the definition of health that says health is not only the absence of disease, which at this point in time we are trying to eliminate, but it is also the presence of a sense of well-being. And another beautiful concept, which I have no time to discuss, is the concept of ginhawa. Ginhawa is not just the absence of disease, but the presence of a quality of life. Now we're talking about survival. I would like to advocate, however, that we do not lose the other one, the presence of a sense of well-being and wholeness in our lives. Finally, the second point of our deliverables is the deliverable of giving each other a sense of empowerment, a sense of community, a sense of power and control over each other's lives. But what are the starting points? And I go back to the beginning of my slide and that's the end. But we always have to go back and come back to ourselves. Go inside our loob, because in the end, we have to start the change from within. And then and only then can we go and move outside, pumunta sa labas, to change others from without, and together we practice pakikipagkapwa tao. Yun lang po, maraming salamat at magandang hapon.